Welcome to a lesson on solving equations in quadratic form. The goal of this video is to solve equations in quadratic form by factoring. Let's start with a review on solving a quadratic equation by factoring. X squared minus x minus 6 equals 0 can be solved by factoring since this trinomial factors into two binomial factors. We start with the factors of x squared, which are x and x. And then we find the factors of negative 6 that add to negative 1, which are negative 3 and positive 2. So we have a minus 3 and a plus 2. This is equal to 0 when these factors are equal to 0, or when x minus 3 equals 0, or x plus 2 equals 0. So our solutions would be x equals 3, or x equals negative 2. Now we want to be able to apply the same technique to equations that are not quadratics as long as they fit the form of a factorable quadratic. The form we want to look for is to see if the square of the variable factor of the middle term, in this case x, is equal to the variable factors of the first term, in this case x squared. So if we square this variable factor here, we want it to equal the variable factors of the first term. So for example, if we want to solve x minus the square root of x minus 6 equals 0, it's not a quadratic equation, but it does fit the form of a quadratic because if we square the square root of x, it does equal x, which means we can rewrite this as the square root of x squared, notice this is equal to x, minus the square root of x minus 6 equals 0. This fits the form of a factorable quadratic. So this will factor into two binomial factors, but now instead of x and x, like we had in the first example, we'll have the square root of x and the square root of x. The factors of negative 6 that add to negative 1 are still negative 3 and positive 2, and now we'll set these factors equal to 0 and solve. So we'd have the square root of x minus 3 equals 0, or the square root of x plus 2 equals 0. So here we'd add 3 to both sides. Square root of x equals 3. Over here we'd have the square root of x equals negative 2. And now to solve for x, we'd have to square both sides of the equation, here as well as here. So it appears we have two solutions, x equals 9 or x equals 4. But one important thing to remember is when applying this technique to non-quadratics, we always need to check these values back into the original equation because sometimes they won't work or they'll be what's called an extraneous solution. So let's take a moment and check these solutions. If x equals 9, we would have 9 minus the square root of 9, which is 3, minus 6 equals 0. Well, that checks. Now let's check x equals 4. If x is 4, we would have 4 minus the square root of 4, which is 2, minus 6 equals 0. And that's not true. So x equals 4 is an extraneous solution, or not a solution to this equation. We only have one solution, which is x equals 9. So it's important that we always check our solutions when using this technique. Let's take a look at some more examples. Here we have x to the 4th plus 4x squared minus 32 equals 0. Again, the first step is to check to see if it fits the form of a factorable quadratic, meaning if we square this variable factor, would it equal x to the 4th? And it would. We can write this as x squared to the 2nd plus 4 times x squared minus 32 equals 0. Sometimes you'll see textbooks perform a u substitution here and write this as u squared plus 4u minus 32. But as long as you recognize this fits the form of a quadratic, there's no need to perform that substitution. So this will factor into two binomial factors. But now instead of having a factor of x and x, we'll have a factor of x squared and a factor of x squared. And from here, it's going to be pretty much the same. We want the factors of negative 32 that add to positive 4, which would be positive 8 and negative 4. This product is equal to 0 when x squared plus 8 equals 0, or when x squared minus 4 equals 0. So here we subtract 8 on both sides, so we'd have x squared equals negative 8, Over here, we would add 4 to both sides. We'd have x squared equals 4. And now to solve for x, we take the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, when we do this, we have to include a plus or minus sign. So here we have x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 8, which we'll simplify in just a moment. Here we have x equals plus or minus 2. Now the square root of negative 8 is equal to the square root of negative 1 times 2 times 2 times 2. So this simplifies to 2. This simplifies to I, so we have 2i square root 2. So here we have x equals plus or minus 2i square root 2. Now remember, we do have to check these solutions. And for this video, we're going to check these on the calculator. If you follow the example videos linked on the screen, I'll check them by hand. We want to make sure that we're in complex mode, so we press the mode key, make sure a plus bi is highlighted, which it is, and now we'll go ahead and check these. So we have negative 2i, which is second decimal point, square root 2 to the fourth, plus 4 times negative 2i square root 2 squared, minus 32. That checks. And now I'm going to press second enter. Brings up the same expression, but now I can just delete the negative signs instead of having to retype the whole expression to check positive 2i square root 2. So I'll delete this and delete this. Press enter. Notice how that checks as well. And now we'll check positive and negative 2. We'll check negative 2 first. So negative 2 to the fourth plus 4 times negative 2 squared minus 32. This checks. Now I'm going to press second enter and just delete the negatives to check positive 2. And that checks as well. So notice all 4 solutions check. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have 2x to the 2 thirds plus 3x to the 1 third minus 20 equals 0. Again, our first step is to check to see if it fits the form of a factorable quadratic. We want to know if we square this variable factor, or x to the 1 third, it will equal x to the 2 thirds. And it will. We can go ahead and write this as 2 times x to the 1 third squared plus 3 times x to the 1 third minus 20 equals 0. And now we can factor this like we normally would, but now instead of having 2x and x, we'll have 2x to the 1 third and x to the 1 third. Now we'll place the factors of negative 20 in the second positions so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to positive 3x to the 1 third. So if we put positive 4 here, and a negative 5 or minus 5 here, notice how we'd have 8x to the 1 third plus negative 5x to the 1 third, which is positive 3x to the 1 third. So now we'll set each of these factors equal to 0. So we have 2x to the 1 third minus 5 equals 0, or x to the 1 third plus 4 equals 0. So we'll isolate the variable factor by adding 5 and dividing by 2. So if x to the 1 third equals 5 halves, or x to the 1 third equals negative 4. To solve this for x, we'll have to raise both sides of the equation to 3. Remember, powers to powers we multiply, and 1 third times 3 is equal to 1. And we'll do the same here. So on the left we have x. 5 to the third is 125. 2 to the third is 8. Here we have x equals negative 4 to the third is negative 64. Let's go ahead and check these on the calculator. So we have 2 times 125 divided by 8 raised to the power of 2 thirds. We do need the exponent in parentheses. Plus 3 times 125 divided by 8 raised to the 1/3 power minus 20. That checks, and now we want to check negative 64. And notice that checks as well. So both solutions check. So this equation has two solutions. Let's take a look at one more. Notice here we have negative exponents, but we're going to follow the same procedure. We first want to check to see if it fits the form of a factorable quadratic. If we square the variable factor of the middle term, which in this case is x to the negative 1, we want to make sure it's equal to x to the negative 2. So if we write 6 times x to the negative 1 squared, notice how this does equal x to the negative 2, so it fits the correct form. So now we can go ahead and factor this. Instead of using factors of x, we'll use factors of x to the negative 1. This one's a little more challenging because of the 6 here. It could be 6 and 1 or 3 and 2. Let's try 6x to the negative 1 and 1x to the negative 1. Notice if we put a negative 1 here or a minus 1 here and a positive 1 here, this works out nicely. We have negative 6x to the negative 1 plus positive 1x to the negative 1, which is equal to negative 5x to the negative 1. So now we'll set each factor equal to 0. We'll have 6x to the negative 1 plus 1 equals 0, or x to the negative 1 minus 1 equals 0. We can write this as 6 divided by x, and then move the 1 over, so it's equal to negative 1. Let's put this over 1. And then from here we can cross multiply. Negative x must equal 6. Divide both sides by negative 1, and we have x equals negative 6. Over here, we can write this as 1 over x, add 1 to both sides, write this as 1 over 1, cross multiply, notice how we have x equals 1. Let's go ahead and check these two solutions. That's equal to 0, which is good. And now we press second, enter, and we'll change the negative 6s to positive 1s. Notice how this checks as well. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. If you want to see more examples, just follow the link on the screen. I hope you found this helpful.